when I was 5 years old, I had my first bone crisis, which was osteonecrosis of the hip joint. It crumbled. I was limping for about 2 years. It was suspected that I had leukemia, rheumatoid arthritis. I was tested for dozens of diseases, cancers, various disorders, and everything came back always negative. I was bedridden for 10 months. I had to lay in this brace for around 18 to 20 hours per day. My orthopedist who operated on me for all my bone crises, he said that, "Nate, you're an enigma." And that's the last person you want to hear that from.
Nathaniel's story is not an exception. It is the rule. Families who are affected by rare diseases really don't have an expert doctor to go to or have continuity of care, and their treatment is very fragmented.
Finally, this was at 14, they tested my marrow for a Gaucher cell. The stain came back positive, and it was finally there. You have Gaucher's disease, it's a genetic disorder. There's no cure.
Gaucher disease is a rare disease. It is due to an enzyme deficiency in the lysosomes of cells, which are garbage factory, if you like, that are involved in breaking down a lipid. And so if there is a deficiency of this enzyme, then the lipid builds up in the lysosomes and the cells get engorged with the lipid. And these lipid-filled cells, which are prominently cells called the macrophages, collect in organs around the body, such as the liver, the spleen, the bone marrow, and the lungs, and cause disease manifestations. And so when we talk about treatment, there are two types of treatment. One is every 2 weeks having infusions of the enzyme. This treatment has been transformative in that it leads to extraordinary reversal of disease in the liver and the spleen and the blood counts. But over time, we've learned that 90% of the enzyme goes into the liver and the spleen. So other organs, if there is disease active, it will continue to progress despite treatment. And so this new treatment that we took a lead role in helping to develop, and it is now approved by the FDA, it's a substrate inhibitor. And it has resulted in very impressive and incremental responses compared to enzyme replacement therapy. And what we learned from that is that Gaucher disease is more than just the macrophages. It is involving many other immune cells. And so that has led us on a path of extraordinary research, where what we've learned is that this lipid is a very potent antigen for the immune system.
Lipids, in general, have some effect on the immune system. So I think that's the most important thing, is to remember that lipids are associated with inflammation, and that inflammation triggers the immune system. And when the immune system is triggered, and if it's triggered aberrantly, it can give rise to all kinds of different cascades that can lead to fibrosis and cancer.
We know that now there is an increase in risk of these Gaucher patients developing cancer, mostly myeloma. And in our study, we found that, so because of accumulation of these lipids in macrophages, all other immune cells which interact with macrophages, like for example, take B cells or T cells, they also get affected. And all of these cells, if there is any dysregulation in these, that can cause cancers, and mostly myeloma in case of Gaucher disease.
A lot of the causes of what drives myeloma is still being investigated, but here we have a very clear disease, and understanding kind of the crosstalk between the different immune cells potentially will help mitigate that process of stimulation.
What we find is that if you reduce this substrate, if you reduce these lipids which are being accumulated in the Gaucher disease by giving substrate reduction therapy, that can actually reduce the formation of gammopathy.
What is remarkable is that this knowledge is helping us to look after individuals with Gaucher disease who develop multiple myeloma. But what we've learned is that one third of multiple myeloma patients in the cancer center actually have the same mechanism for the development of multiple myeloma. So here is a rare disease that is illuminating a common disease. And I can tell you the same story with Parkinson's disease.
Gaucher patients are at 20-fold risk for getting Parkinson's. We are trying to see if certain lipid molecules that accumulate in Gauchers are actually increasing your risk for Parkinson by interacting with a protein called synuclein, which clumps in patients' brain. So we think the lipids are triggers for synuclein clumping.
The primary treatment for Gaucher disease is enzyme infusions and substrate reduction therapy. And they cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. That's a major caveat right now. There are clinical trials that are being held over at Yale. So these substrates can cross the blood-brain barrier.
The other thing that our work says is maybe we could have biomarkers.
If we are able to identify these patients who are going to develop neurological manifestations later on, using some biomarkers, we can change their lives.
What we are doing at Yale is doing whole genome sequencing in more than 500 patients with Gaucher disease. It is the largest patient population that has ever been assembled.
Not everybody with Gaucher disease looks the same. So even though it's a single genetic disorder, there are multiple mutations in this particular gene.
With the whole exome sequencing, whole genome sequencing, you can look for these rare variants. We can really tell the potential functional relevance of each rare variant. So this gives us some information about the genes, the pathways involved in the Gaucher disease etiology. You need a lot of data there to really have a very comprehensive understanding about both the genetic factors and also lifestyles, other factors, how they contribute to common diseases. And those information, again, also will be helpful to understand the rare disease as well.
I never thought that this would happen. I never thought that I'd get to this point. I never thought, you know, I'd be able to go to medical school. I'd be able to genuinely have an impact on patients' lives through patient advocacy, to genuinely have an impact on the science behind Gaucher disease and research. And I never thought that I wouldn't have to go to sleep worrying that I'll wake up with pain in the morning and have to go to the surgery. But all of that is gone now. I'm happy, you know, there's nothing in my way stopping me.
In our program, we really have developed a culture of providing holistic care. So we want to provide science-based, cutting-edge therapies and apply the most advanced technologies in the world to assess Gaucher disease. But we don't want to forget that person behind it.
And there's something very important that Dr. Mistry taught me, which is that the patient should be the center of everything you do. So you can't compartmentalize being a clinician and being a researcher. If you lovingly capture all of the information that your patients give you, you can actually really come up with groundbreaking questions that can change their lives.
I think that armed with the tools that we have in the 21st century, no patient should be an enigma. We should be able to get to the root cause of their ill health and fix it.